Visual reveal. Are you guys ready? 3, 2, and... What's up, guys? It's your boy, Shane. Welcome back to a brand new vlog. Where today, we have a secret project to announce. So, yeah, let's get straight into it without further ado. So, currently I've been working on a secret project. It's an aquatic project. The last aquatic project we did was bubbles, which I didn't really vlog much. My apologies for that, though. I should have gotten more footage before, you know. He had left us. So, what happened to Bubbles anyways? So, Bubbles ended up, he did end up dying. Unfortunately, the fall of Bubbles was, really tragic. He didn't really last for as long as I wanted, but this time, I know I've done more research, and this time we're gonna end up getting back a beta fish, no doubt. No doubt a beta fish will come back. But, until then, I've decided to go something a little bit bigger, in a sense. And I've decided to make a pond. Now, there was a bit of construction to do. Now, when you guys are thinking pond, you're probably thinking something in-ground, right? This one's not really in-ground. This one's out-ground. This one's above ground. It's gonna be a balcony pond, or, yeah. And I know there's some that are like DIY out there and stuff like that. And, but this one's kind of DIY, kind of not. In a sense. Well, yeah, it is a do-it-yourself pond because no one's really building it for you, but... when you're thinking of DIY, this is not really of a cheap DIY. This is more of a... you're actually putting some effort into it kind of thing. Not saying that cheap DIYs have no effort. There's a lot of creativeness and stuff that goes behind cheap DIYs. But this one actually... I wanted it to be a cheap DIY, but it ended up being expensive, kind in a sense. Well, expensive because it was basically... it was over $100. And, we made it so that we can accommodate for a pond. Now, construction of the pond, like, so basically, it'll make more sense when I actually show it to you. But, what we did was we created, gave it kind of like a hot tub design. So we bought an actual pond tub from Home Depot. It was like $77, $78. And, we took, wood, and we carved out the shape for it. And we lifted it up above ground, so it's not really touching, and it gets support. And we made like, and it kind of looks like a hot tub, because you know hot tubs, they have that barrier, they have that like, how do I explain it? They have like a space where you can walk around the hot tub, and then there's the actual pool of the hot tub. That's what it kind of looks like here. And yes, we did build that off camera, unfortunately. I thought of recording it, but I was like, it was debatable for me, and I chose not to go with it. If you guys did want to see that, comment down that you did, and because this ain't going to be our first project. We have way more aquatic projects. I'm not saying that this channel is going to lead to a fishing aquatic project or a channel. It's a nature channel, and I decided to reconnect with nature side of it. By that, I mean getting, like, seeing the natural stuff, like fish and whatnot. Fish was just one of the things I wanted to do. And right now, to be honest, it's one of the most easiest things I can get my hands on right now. Okay, dog's no longer trapped. Alright. So we are now here. So, oh god, this is gonna be dark. Will it work better like this? Yeah, it'll work better like this. So, you guys can barely see it. I don't want you guys to clearly see it yet, and that's a lot of blur. Will it work like this? Yes, it will. Okay. So, I have the fish pond right beside us. I cleaned it out earlier today, like, let's say, what's today? Today, well, I know today. Today's the... The time? Right now it's about, what, after 6, maybe even... Yeah, 6, maybe 7. After 6, maybe 7. 7 to 7:30, let's just say, as a time limit. 3 o'clock today. 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Okay, not 3 o'clock. 3:30 is a good time estimation. 3:30, I actually went out, took the actual tub, and gave it a wash down. You could, I don't know if you guys could see that, but now, for the actual reveal. Are you guys ready? 3, 2, and boot. Boom. There it is, guys. All right, so this is the pond that I was making. So as you can see, like I said, the hot tub type design with this kind of, with this like space where you could just walk around, like if it was an actual hot tub. And we just filtered around. Oh, it has bends. Before this curve, there's supposed to be a filter, maybe even a waterfall filter if I'm feeling good about it myself. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. My dad put an access door here so that way I can get easy access. Okay, that's not easy access. So easy access. This door itself is a 12 by 12 door, so you could it doesn't fill it like to complete. It's probably 13 by 13 or something like that. Something of the sort, because as you can see, look, it doesn't fill it in all the way. So that's not a problem. I just don't want animals to go in there, and I want quick and easy access if I have to go under there. Now, back to the pond itself. The dimensions of this pond, the dimensions itself, I don't know, but this is a 60-gallon pond. So if you're a person that does tanking and stuff like that, that does like aquariums, and you know what a 60-gallon tank is, just imagine that, but in a pond. And what I like about this design is, one, it has this nice shallow bit where the fish that we add, they could just swim around here, rest around here. And then when the night falls, now I'm gonna try to make this as easy as possible, but the filter is gonna come in this deep part. How I'm gonna make it so the fish get this? Now, this filter I got at Home Depot, it's a multi-filtration system, and it'll make the water crystal clear. Okay, I've seen videos of this stuff working. 60 gallons, 2 liters, that will be exactly 230 liters of water, or of a pond. Okay, now this is the type of pond. This is removable. Okay, I don't know. All right, yeah, see this? This is removable. We cut it out of plywood. That's removable. I literally yanked this thing down there, and I took the hose, washed it, and then literally made a trip back up from the house to do it. Now, little did I know, was throwing it, I was actually gonna make dents. No, I made dents, not needed dents. And basically what happened was that, so we kept getting like, the big koi just kept disappearing. And what we did was we started putting mini goldfish. We had mini goldfish in our house. And then what we did, we started putting mini goldfish into that pond. They barely came up from the water. And we barely got to see them at all. With 5 feet of deep water, they're gonna dive down, guys. Goldfish will definitely dive down to the deepest part of the water. Trust me. And every now and then they would come up and swim. We added a waterfall. And man, will I just tell you, that waterfall changed the whole aspect of that pond. Fish kept coming to the surface now. They were coming to the surface more often. They even tried to jump against the waterfall, and it was pretty cool because, and one thing with that is that we made it safe, so even though they did jump, no matter what, they always will fall back in that pond. And they would always fall back in the pond safely. No scratches, no bumps on. They wouldn't bump into anything. And they definitely wouldn't flop out of the water. With this, though, with the waterfall, I could already see that if these koi... Now, I'm not going to put giant monster koi. Like, you see those... Sorry, I need to keep... So I can get the proper lighting. I don't want those, like, giant monster koi that just come out and, you know, take over half of the pond. I want, like, mini koi, and, like, maybe five or six of them. Maybe even, depending on how big they are, maybe even 10 koi, to be honest. And, I want to have, like, a mini koi pond here, but the only problem is that I only want to start off with 5 for now, because I don't know what the plan is for winter. Now, this is only the start of summer, almost near the end of spring. I don't know what I want to do with them for the winter, so with these months going by, I get some sort of idea what I want to do, and with high school coming on, it's not going to be easy, but anyways, aside from that, taking it one day at a time. Right? So, like I said, getting back on track. So, all of aside from telling you about those ponds, I'm just saying that a waterfall does add more aspect to it, but at the same time, you gotta be careful, and you gotta know what you're doing with waterfalls, because if I know exactly, I know koi do jump. Our koi didn't jump as much, but koi do indeed. Other than that, we can let them acclimate overnight on Thursday, if we do get them, but Thursday's a if. Friday, I'll guarantee. Guarantee Friday, because we have to take this boy. Where's this boy at anyways? That boy. He has to go to the groomers on Friday. So while we're going to PetSmart to leave him to groom, I'm not getting fish from PetSmart. I'm getting them from Big Al's, because Big Al's is something that promises our people inside. We need to start the filtration system. Now, I was working on a few ideas earlier, so I know what I'm going to do in the vlog. Because half of it, yes, I will spend time doing my... just trying to figure out what I want to put. But I don't want the whole vlog to be what I want to put. So some vlogs, episodes, what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to off-camera try to figure out different ideas and then not really put together, but... wait till the vlog, and then put them together and everything. So this is going to be a step-by-step how to build a pond, and also, after that, we will also do some crazy things with these fish, maybe some live feedings with worms, different things, different insects that we find in the deep down grounds, stuff like that. We can do some live feedings like that, and we can train them to be our very own personal pets. So, without further ado, let's head on inside and get the stuff, all right? Alright guys, so we are back. Excuse for my messy room, but it will be cleaned up on the weekend. Anyway, so as I was saying, so let's go looking for the stuff. God damn. Computer, move. Computer, get in there. Alright. Boy. Alright, so boy, we got some stuff over here. Blow dryer stuff we're not gonna need. This stuff in this bin's not needed. So we're just gonna just ignore those, to be honest. Cause I don't need it. I was thinking more for the bait stuff. Anyways. What we need are these bad boys. These filters stuff. This is the box stuff. Now, I'm saying we should work on this outside. Ugh. So that's some filtered stuff. Let's go outside.
Can't you see I'm calling? A guy like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous, I'm falling. There's no escape,
guys, so we are back outside and we got the stuffs. Now, what I'm gonna end up doing is I'm gonna switch to cap can, so yeah, we'll go to cap can and I can use both of my hands. So I will see you guys in a bit. Once again. Alright guys, so welcome back to the cap can videos. Hope you guys still do enjoy cap can videos. Cap cam. So what are we going to do? So we're going to take these things. We have our pump. This is, now I know it looks dirty, but I washed it out and this is as much dirt as I can get out. And the dirt does not leak or does not, you know, come off. So we should be good for now, filtration wise. And besides, either way, the filter is still going to. Now, this stuff, on the other hand, the dirt did seep through to this side. I will wash it in the end. As you can see, I hope you guys can see this. I didn't really test it out much. Consider this test one. Leave it in the comments if I passed. So I'm just going to throw this water out there. Doesn't matter. So, according to the paper, see the paper. I need to go get another cork. These medias in here. On this side. On this side. And angle it. Right, doesn't angle that way. Corked it. Now these wires. Okay. This wire goes here. Okay? This wire goes here. And we put the biomedia in here. So, with this filtration system, there's about three biological filters that are happening here, and only two are mechanical, which is great. The more of an ecosystem we create for this, the better. So, okay, let's pretend that's how it is. It's pretty sturdy either way. So we're just gonna take out this biomedia. I think that's what it's called. It's either biomedia or media itself. Right. Cuts us some slicks. So, will this PVC piping? Okay. So now we just cut this PVC piping. It's not called PVC. I'm so stupid. I'm giving the wrong information. It's not PVC, guys. If you guys go and ask them for PVC at Home Depot, they're not going to give you this. They're not going to give you this piping. They're not gonna give it to you. Get tubing. Don't get pipe. Pipe and tube or something else. You guys are probably smart enough to know that, but in case you guys are new to this and you guys did not know, then yeah, that's your hashtag facts for the day. All right. Let me just slip the biomedia in here because we are just savages. Complete savages. Now, there are going to be holes. If you guys buy the exact same thing, there will be holes. Just saying. Don't worry about it. It's going to be A-okay. Your thing will still filter fine. It's not going to... Alright. So, if you guys have this kind of thing, save it. Do not throw it away. Don't make that mistake I did one time. Don't do that. And look, guys, here we go. Here you have it. I'm going to take the hat off so you guys could just see the perfect view of it. There it is, and it's pride and glory. The biomedia filter that was going to make... This is the thing that I was talking about earlier that makes your water crystal clear. Now, in a sense that it makes it crystal clear, it'll also keep it very... very healthy for the pond, like the beneficial bacteria and stuff like that. That'll still be in here, right? Now, if we were to plan this correctly, we're not going to be in cap can anymore because we don't need cap can. So we are going to switch back to the regular cam. Three. All right. Yeah. So we'll be back. Three, two, back to this. So we are going to connect this properly. Now, So yeah, this is the final product that you should get after putting your pump. Keep in mind that they, Home Depot, this thing does not come with the pump, so don't expect much with the pump, that for them to come with a pump. It's not going to come with pump.
Kind of come with a pump. Okay.
So don't expect much from them. So this is my idea, and it's safe, totally safe for the fish in, because I know everybody has this thing where the fish likes to try to get trapped and commits suicide or get sucked in by the thing. This will prevent that. That's a major thing I'm really happy about. It'll prevent that. No, at absolute ground zero. Zero. There should be a 0% chance of your fish swimming in that if they... If it does, then I guess you guys can hold me off on that. Okay. You guys can sue me for your fish. If that will make your life happy, go ahead. Alright. So now what I want to do is throw that cord... I'm not throwing that cord over. We're not going to throw the cord over. Now, here, if you guys have this kind of thing, now I know you guys don't. Alright, guys, so we're kind of outside. Dude, all this running... Guys, if you guys are making a pond that is completely on the highest floor of your house, if you guys decide to do what I do and make it on the highest floor of the of your house, my suggestion to you is good luck. Because, to be honest, this is hard work. I gotta try to throw it up there. No one's there to catch it for me.
Segel. Come on, Segel. Respect Segels.
Alright. Anyways, like I was saying. So yeah, I got... Yoink. Did not go well. So... Attemption Zumber Zoo. Alright. Damn it, I stepped on it. Attemption number zoo.
Attemption number three.
It was a trip and a half we made. Like, literally. I had to run. Alright, so here's what happened. So as this is filling up, let me tell you the story of how, after 2 years later, I finally got this up, so I no longer tried to throw it because I saw that was getting us nowhere. So what I did instead was I attached this wire here, this black wire, all the way down. Let's attach that light, and I tried to pull up the wire thing. I pulled it up finally, went to unloose it. Thing was caught on a wood. It's caught on that wood. Had to move it. As I was removing it from up here, I was like pulling at it to unloose it. The whole thing fell. So I had to go take out the wood for myself from down there, do the whole wire thing again, put it in here, run back down, release the water, and quickly run back up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add an aquarium heater because I do have that on me, on hand. It's tiny, guys. It's so tiny. It's not going to do it, but... What I'm going to do is I'm going to let it run for two whole days. Two, maybe even three whole days. Which means Tuesday tonight, so after this thing's finished, I'm going to wait. So tonight, all of Wednesday, maybe all of Thursday, and Friday I'll finally put the fish in. So that's when I'll maybe take the heater off if the water's not that cold. If the water's not that hot. If the water's not that cold, I'll do that. So, I don't know why... Oh, it actually worked. The whole thing. Literally, guys, look, it's not sinking anymore. Look at that. Now, I want to see the airflow of this thing. So what I'm going to end up doing, so this is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to put on the filter. No, I'm going to wait till it fills up to the top. When it reaches till about, let's see, here, reaches here, it'll thing. So yeah, this thing is going to be, let's just say it's cold, okay? Like, let's say you just put your tap on. Okay, I'll compare it to this. Let's just say you put your tap on, right? Friday, that's a fact. But putting them might not even come till the weekend. Not even the weekend. Maybe Saturday. Well, yeah, that's the weekend, but still. Maybe Saturday afternoon, because we are going to London for Father's Day. It's coming, which is flowing, and while I'm running down. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to yoit this hose all the way over, shut it off, and then, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, mosquitoes are finally coming around. I don't know if you can see them, but they are flying in front of the lens. I literally just... Okay, so originally on my leg, I had about 3, maybe 4 mosquito bites. I just got them to finally go away. I'm not ready for them to come back. Damn, neighbors are loud. So, as you can see, this water's filling up really fast. Really, really fast. Look at this. Up till here. So I'm going to leave that to fill. What I might do is actually I might plug in the pond filter now. And we're going to see how it really works with this water. So let's just do that. How am I going to do this? Okay, this might not work. Let there be light, my child, in this pond. Okay. So I just put it on. This is actually I think, and we'll be right back. The Bat Army is coming to see the pond's final makings. I gotta make sure this thing doesn't overflow. Anyway, so yeah. Move that more close. My hands are freezing, guys. My hands are flipping freezing. As in no. Hey. Did enjoy this episode. If you guys did, don't forget to smack that subscribe button if you guys are new. If you guys are new, join us on our crazy adventures that we go on every now and then. I'm gonna start being more frequently. I made that promise a long time ago. I'm gonna keep that promise, okay? Can't say I haven't failed you yet. Can only say I failed you when this vlog channel is over. Anyways, but until then. Oh, this thing is almost pretty much done. So, like I said, you guys are new. Subscribe. Join us on our crazy adventures. And if you guys are already subscribed, you guys know what the deal is. Punch that like button as hard as you can. Comment down any ideas, any suggestions you have, any suggestions for fish ideas. You guys have fish ideas, suggest that down below. If you guys have any other things you want to see added to the pond that may not even fish, could be even plants, name them down below. That will help us out here with our pond. And I guess that's all from me. And without further ado, like I said before, hope you guys enjoyed this epic video, and we will see you guys in the next one. Peace, guys.